Okay, might be Marhaini is preparing herself. I want to introduce the Institute for Women Empowerment in Indonesia, where the Marhaini work for. So it seems that Institute for Women Empowerment is like, it is like international network, like the home net. These organizations has the focus on research and advocacy. So the Institute for Women Empowerment working in the four continent, Africa, North America, and Asia, and registered in Indonesia in 2016. If I see from the websites, this organization is established by the feminists. So interesting, in the last 5 years, this the Institute for Women Empowerment has conducted a study in their partner in the remote area to see how the genuine value of SSE founded in their daily activity. I think Marhaini will present one of the very interesting case from the South Sulawesi. Marhaini, are you there?
Yeah, dengar, okay. Dengar?
Yeah.
Are you heard? Yeah. Yes, Mas Chandra, yes. Can you show my presentation?
Okay. Maybe you can start. You want to introduce yourself while I'm preparing the
Yes. My name is Marhaini Nasution from Institute for Women Empowerment, not Institute of Women Empowerment, but for Women Empowerment. My name is Marhaini Nasution from Institute for Women Empowerment. Actually, Institute for Women Empowerment focus in many issues. Actually, there is land right, religious fundamentalism, in the last years ago, and SSE talking about the economic and the oasis. Maybe you know that the oasis is well-being, self-care, and integrated security. And the last one is women's leadership. Women leadership is talking about the, if you know, maybe the FLTS, we abbreviation of Feminist Leadership Transformative Sustainability. So itu our focus. Even though so many focus in the Institute for Women Empowerment, but our fulcrum is, our core is women empowering. That even we talk about many issues, but women empowering is our focus. So even though we talk about the SSE, we see about the women empowerment. So actually, every Institute for Women Empowerment focus in SSE from 2012. From 2012, we and our partner joined together, working together to build up the SSE in Indonesia, especially in the women focus. And 2013, we joined together with our partner also, went to the fifth repast in the Manila at the first time. And after that, after back to Manila, we built up and we developed SSE Indonesia with the program and the project implementing in Indonesia. So many organization involved that our program, but male domination also joined together and build up the SSE. Even though the course of the concept of the SSE still blur at that time, but we try slowly but sure to focus on the SSE. And we remember that in 2015, when we came to the Manila is talking about five dimension. After talking that five dimension, we back to Indonesia, talking with our partner, how the five dimension we see that, and we see the SSE and how to mapping out the SSE. So that is the how, why we talking about the five dimension, and we did the mapping SSE in Indonesia. At the first time, we have the consensus with our partner, 15 organization, women organization. But the first step, we joined together with our partner, three organization. That is why we the first step is it is the three organization. Next slide, Chandra. Okay, this is our finding, our mapping. We call the women community practices in social solidarity economy in organization, three organization in Asia. Next slide, Chandra. Okay, from the three organization, the first one is the Comunitas Suabina. We call it Suabina Community, rural Salasai rural, and the second one is the Islamic boarding school. Also talk about the agriculture, the same one with the Suabina Community. But the third one is we join together with home-based worker, women home-based worker. So right now I would like to give the presentation community, Suabina community. That is the pictures of the Suabina community. It's very beautiful places, very fresh and clean the community. Next slide. Okay, next slide. And I would like to introduce the Suabina community located in the Sulawesi. You can reach, if you want to going to the Suabina community, you can reach using by sea transportation 2 days, and 2 days one night. And you can also going by plane 2 hours. So it is the condition, it is far from Jakarta, Indonesia. So if you want to going to there, you can reach by sea or you can reach by plane. So the you know that KSPS, we abbreviation of the Komunitas Suabina Pedesaan Salasae, Suabina community abbreviation is KSPS, is an organic farmer organization with the variety agriculture products, and they have also the market over there, self-managed market. Salasai itself consists of five hamlet, population approximately 3,300, and the consists of the farmer, it is around 170 people, and a breeder is 222, yeah, and others activity. And right now, there have been 2,000 farmer, and consists of the 132, yes. And you know that Salasai village has an 100 hectare of the paddy organic right now, and 400 hectare farm. That is the general information about the Suabina community. The next one. Next slide. And you see that. The background of the why KSPS established, you know that since 2011, the situation in the Salasae village has changed a lot. Many young people and the farmer had left their village and were reluctant to become farmers. They prefer to migrate and become migrant workers rather than taking care of their village and the farmer. And the fact Salasae itself has long been one of the village that have a vast agriculture area, and the farming is the main livelihood for the community. The decline in the crop yield is due to the decreased soil fertility from the use of the pesticide and chemical fertilizer, which continues to decrease in the number and ultimately causes soil nutrient to continue to decrease. This situation have pushed people in the community to get caught in debt to the middleman, money lender, and eventually they become this is the situation of the Salasae when the 2011 and before. And if you see that the pictures in above, in top, people hold the coke, that is coke fighting, because they are finally very frustrated about the situation of their soil, and then they become the coke fighter and the illegal logging and the drinker and many things that the situation in the past. And the next slide. So, seeing the situation, people took the initiative, few people, to form an integrated agriculture. Why the integrated agriculture? Because they think that they have the integrated with agriculture, where they have to have agriculture and market over there. So for 6 months, they discussed day and night to make an organization. So it is a very hard at the time, because it is very hard to realize many people got failed. And the KSPS then developed a method to get people interested in the becoming farmer again. Natural farming is an option by utilizing natural ingredient cheap and easily obtained in the Salasae village. And the next slide, Chandra. And I would like to see, as you mentioned before, five dimension of the SSE, but in the Institute for Women Employment and the partner agree and have the consensus that we have to put it one dimension. At one dimension is gender mainstreaming. And you see that if the one socially responsible governance, and the second edifying ethical value, and the third one is social economic benefit of the community, and the fourth ecological conservation, five is economic sustainable, and the sixth one is we put it gender dimension. And if we see the platform, each dimension, we put it also the gender part. For example, actually in our mapping, we see that the supply input, production, and the marketing, and also the distribution and the marketing. Each part, we put it also gender over there. And if we see dimension one, socially responsible government, in the Salasae, involve poor and marginalized people in organization of the KSPS. They come from the various background. Various background, it means that from the youth, from women and men over there, without discrimination based on social status and education. Actually, the most of them is lower educated. Lower educated, it means that they are from the elementary school and also junior high school. There is no less people or a little bit from the senior high school and the university. So this is the situation. Yeah? And then all members in KSPS organization have the right in the decision-making organization, even in the planning, implementation, and the monitoring and evaluation. That is, and actually they have the structure. Even they have the structure, but the structure itself, the function of the structure, just easy to manage and facilitate to the member. No power structure over there, because if we talk about the structure, hierarchical, many management or board or person in the position, they always discriminate the people advocated. No, like that.
This, just reminding, you have 9 minutes left.
Oh, 9 minutes left.
Marhaini. Yeah.
Okay.
Just reminding.
All the members, the KSPS also involved in the social economic project. The most important thing, that no competition, just cooperation, supporting one each other to the capacity building for those who want to develop natural agriculture and economic. And then next slide, Chandra. Okay, we see the identifying ethical values. If we see the ethical values in that the organization, solidarity and the mutual cooperation over there, and the seeing every person is important. Well, this is like the icon in the Salasae, seeing every one person is important. You see that no one is not important, because people is very important one by one. We see also the justice of a resource. They divided the resource very justice. For example, in the farmer, if they decided in the what we call it yield crop, they sell yield crop to the corporation. The decision based on the farmer. So that is a very justice of a resource. And that democratic also, and transparency, joint market, profit to every entities, profit to sharing, and preserve and maintain natural resources of production. Next slide. Chandra, next slide. This is the dimension three is socio-economic benefit of the community. That the KSPS, Suwabina community, the great job for men, women, and youth over there. We can see later on, the next slide. Also, we can see access to education, access to education, and access to market, access to funding, loan funding to deposit, and the saving cooperative and the form of the union, and then it increased capacity related to many things, especially women in this case. They have the capacity building to organic farming, organization also, they have the capacity building organization, market, cooperative, preserving the environment and the medcraft and etc. Okay, the situation of the COVID right now, so far they have nothing problem, because they have a system can handle it. So maybe we have to see later on. Okay, next slide. Chandra, this is the ecological conservation. The fourth dimension, members of the KSPS have the strong awareness of the environmental conservation in the village. The use of microbes from various natural materials such as the vegetable, fish bone, fish grass, straw, and etc. And maybe you know that related with the ecological conservation, KSPS run the climate change program. Maybe you know that the climate change program is talk about the mitigation and adaptation program. So the mitigation itself is talking about the reduced emission greenhouse gases. And if you talk about the mitigation and adaptation, you have to adapt with the climate change itself. So this is their activities with the climate change adaptation program. Biopoly, the top one picture, and making reservoir and the rainwater harvesting, RORAC, and then what else? This one and RORAC and the terracing and irrigation system. If maybe you have to know about that that one. And the next slide, Chandra. Next slide. The second one, if you talking about the climate change adaptation program, they also have the composting, also 3R activities, utilization of the plastic waste into bunkies and the part into doormat. You know that the 3R is the recycle, reducing, and the reuse. They also did this youth people taking this the program 3R, and also they have the program biogas from Kodang, and organic fertilizer and tree planting. Every citizen, this is very very important that every citizen plant 500 trees in that village. And the function is serve to keep water available. In the one hand, and also become old age saving for sale in the future. And they also won the trophy of Sustainable Climate Program proclaim from the Ministry of the Environment and Forestry in 2017. Okay, next slide, Chandra. Economic sustainability, the five dimension, they get sufficient generating income from their product, from the livestock and rice, horticultural product. And they also creating a fair trade system for all farmers, and makes the farmer as the owner of the organization and involved in the every decision making process. And you know that the COVID-19 pandemic does not have the negative impact to the KSPS community. They live as usual. This is the because of the system has already run strong, integrated with the strong values and the principle. They have the food independence with the principle of the itself sufficient, subsistent itself. The subsistence and the self-managed economic system example is cooperative. They have the cooperative over there, the self-management market in that organization. The next one. Next slide.
Just yes, to remind you, 1 minute left, Marhaini. Sorry.
Okay, next slide. Chandra, this is the gender dimension, poor marginalization, uneducated people, both women and men involved in the organization without differentiated. They have the right to access, see everyone is important. So women get involved in decision-making organization, in the planning, implementation, and the monitoring evaluation. And the most important thing that their voice is heard. So women get involved in organization structure of KSPS. Women become particular concerned to KSPS. This is indicated by the formation of the Natural Women Farmer Group, abbreviation of the KPPA in Indonesia, and the Salasai Women Farmer Group KPPS. The KPPS ensure equal access to ownership and the control of a productive asset and the financial resource, such as credit, access to education. And the women is actively participate in economic activities from providing input, production, distribution, and marketing. They also realize that gender role can be changed. Women not just in the private sector, care work, clean home, take care, elderly, send the child to school, like that, and the men in the public sector. So, and division of role in the household change, redistribution of care work. And we know that the social norm that men, that because they have received a man's responsibility related with gender, the social norm is changed, become women can be leader if they have get same access and control over resources. Next slide. Next slide. Chandra. Okay, this is a challenge. Still many farmers have a mindset to use excess chemical fertilizer and pesticide in getting more agricultural product. And the second one is agriculture policy. Policies have become a big threat to farmer. Among others are the protection of new variety of the seed plant. You know that even they, from the elementary school and junior high school, but because very much capacity building over there, they also understand about what the link between WTO and the grassroots. For they are very worried about the agriculture policies. Especially in the new varieties of seed plant, because the cases. Next slide. This is the contribution to achievement of the SDGs goal. SSE practices in the Salasai community contribute to the achievement of SDGs objective, including related to the SDGs 1, to reducing poverty, SDGs 4, quality education, SDGs 5, gender mainstreaming, SDGs 8, related with work, and SDGs 13, SDGs 15 is life on land. Next slide. Okay, this is the phrase we have. No work before sitting. It's mean that before work, we have to talk about much, we have to discuss about much, and then we are going to work. Every day, they carried out about this phrase. And to see everyone is important, it means that everyone is important, no one is not important. Third, and the third one is from us, by us, for us. This is the slogan or the icon of the cooperative in Indonesia. So inherent, the phrase inherent in life. Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms. Mahani, for the very comprehensive presentation. Sorry, last week we couldn't entertain you because of time. But I think you have presented very clearly with the five dimensions. And I say five dimensions plus two, because you brought gender dimension very strongly. And you also brought SDGs in the framework strongly. We will afterwards open for discussion time. And I'm sure Dr. Eri and Dr. Ben will have more points to raise.